GarageBand for Mac has dozens of presets or patches that you can use to apply all manner of effects to your recordings. These patches act as a fantastic starting point when it comes to editing and mixing your projects, but did you know that you can create and save your own patches as well? In this quick tip, I'll show you how. Okay, so first things first, you'll need to have a software instrument, audio or drummer track that you've recorded into. For this backing vocals track, I've started with a patch from GarageBand's library pane. You can open the library pane by clicking on the library icon in the top left or by hitting the keyboard shortcut Y. In this instance, I chose the bright vocal preset. I've manually tweaked the EQ settings, removed any unneeded effects from the plugins menu, and added a third-party pitch correction plugin too. Now, if I want to have this backing vocal preset that I've created available for use across multiple projects, I just need to hit save at the bottom of the library pane, give my preset a name, choose where on my Mac it will be saved. It does make sense to save it in the audio folder though, as that's where all the other GarageBand library patches are stored, and then hit save. Now, if I open an audio track in a new GarageBand project, you can see in the User Patches section of the library pane, my custom backing vocals patch has been saved and all of the plugins, EQ settings and effects will be applied when I select it just as I saved them. This works in exactly the same way for software instruments and drummer tracks too. If I open a new software instrument track and select a previously created user patch from the library menu, the instrument used, effects, and EQ settings load up ready to be used in this new project. It's actually a great way to build out your own custom collection of software instruments. That'll do it for this quick tip. I've been Patrick from thegarageBandguide.com. Bye for now.